The fact that we don't really have to think about our poop is one of the greatest, most unexamined luxuries of modern life in the developed world. As Victor Hugo once famously wrote, "The history of men is reflected in the history of sewers." So even though this video is titled The History of Poop, it's really about the swift removal of waste helping shape where and how we live our lives. This is how Roman shit sticks, Queen Elizabeth's inappropriate godson, and yes, the notorious Thomas Crapper helped free so many of us from chamber pots, cholera, and communal latrines. Naturally, when nature called early humans, they'd answer out in nature. But even the vengeful Old Testament God implored us to be careful about where we drop our ancient deuces. But in 3200 BC, we upgrade. Mesopotamians in the city of Uruk take their BMs indoors with one of the earliest pit toilets, which is basically a giant hole that everyone poops in. Then, in ancient Rome, around 700 BC, there are about 150 public toilets that feed directly into the Cloaca Maxima, an early version of a sewer system that drains into a nearby river. Which brings us to the first entry in the crappiest moments in human history. Unfortunately for everyone, including us who now have to think about this, the public Roman poopers all share one sponge on a stick to clean themselves off, which was not often replaced and is very, very gross. That was the crappiest moments in human history. Anyway, at-home defecation isn't much better. Some dwellings have toilets that aren't connected to sewers, as residents fear rats would crawl through the drains and into their homes. And most people just use chamber pots, which they literally just toss into the streets. At this point, some cultures utilize human waste as fertilizer, commonly called night soil. And medieval architects designed literal poop chutes that protrude from castle walls, sometimes even hanging over cliffs. For the most part, toilet tech remained relatively stagnant until the late 1500s. Godson of Queen Elizabeth and extremely unsuccessful poet John Harrington, coincidentally a direct relative of Kit Harrington, is banished from court for telling too many risque jokes. Basically, he got canceled. But he was so bored in exile, he develops the world's first flushing toilet, which uses an overhead water basin to clear out waste. Even though the queen loved John's idea, and it's the reason we call the toilet the John, Harrington's idea doesn't fully catch on until the 1700s, when Scottish mechanic Alexander Cummings develops the S-trap, which keeps a small amount of water inside toilet bowls and blocks smells, rats, and everything else from seeping up poop pits into people's homes. Essentially, we still use Cummings' concept in modern toilets. But at this point, it's still just a high-tech chamber pot. Fast forward to the 1800s. The overpopulated city of London is facing a major cholera epidemic, and shit is literally flooding the streets. By studying a map of outbreaks in relation to public water pumps, local doctor John Snow discovers that drinking stool-contaminated water directly leads to the spread of disease, which informs the way we dispose of waste and design the places we live. Now, the concept of flush toilets and sewers are combined in holy scatological matrimony. In 1857, the first commercially available toilet paper was invented by the Scott brothers. Before then, people used corn cobs or book pages. The Farmer's Almanac even has a hole in it to hang in your bathroom, which must have made those writers feel very proud of their work. In the late 1870s, English inventor and sanitation engineer Thomas Crapper, who is often falsely credited with inventing the flush toilet, is the biggest name in feces. He famously showcases his newfangled toilets in showrooms, normalizing the idea for the masses. By the 1930s, American lawmakers, via advice from medical professionals, create laws and plumbing codes to ensure hygienic means of waste disposal throughout the U.S. And indoor plumbing, for the most part, is widespread and regulated. In the 1940s, a dock supervisor in Long Beach, California, is sick of his workers making the long trip to a nearby John. So he develops the first porta potty, The portable toilet is then implemented across construction sites, festivals, planes, trains, and buses. Which actually brings us to our second entry in the crappiest moments in human history. In 2004, a Dave Matthews Band tour bus accidentally unloads 800 pounds of raw sewage onto an architectural boat tour passing on the Chicago River, which is only the second biggest piece of DMB has released. You know, after all of their music. Just kidding. Anyway, that was the crappiest moments in human history. In 2021, aka now. After Green Day's seminal 1994 pop-punk masterpiece Dookie, the biggest modern advance in kaka culture unquestionably comes from Japan, where high-tech smart commodes commonly feature built-in bidets, heaters, timers, deodorizers, and sometimes even pleasant music to help get those bowels moving. It's clear we've come a long way from shared fecal sponges and crapping over cliff sides. But it's important to note that billions of human beings still live without sanitary bathroom conditions. So we included links to a couple initiatives that look to solve and aid this problem throughout the world in our description. In the end, we salute the Herculean efforts human beings have made to make chamber pots obsolete and indoor plumbing an existential afterthought. Let's hear a round of congratulatory flushes for all the people who brought us here. Now, if you'll excuse me, I have to go find my farmer's almanac. Hey y'all, if you like this video, make sure to subscribe to our channel and comment on what you want us to cover next. We might not actually do it, but we'll definitely read the comment. Thanks!